Good evening and welcome. And that was Bandmaster John Lamb and the Canadian Staff Band, who you've come to share with in worship this evening. And I just want to say welcome to each of you here. Welcome to each of you who are watching via live stream. And this evening's concert is actually a part of a bit of a joint venture today. Earlier today, we had the first ever Territorial Composer Day put off by the Music and Gospel Arts Department along with the Canadian Staff Band. I'm not going to share too much now because Marcus Venables is going to share a little more about that later, but it's been a really good day together. We want to move right into our music and worship, so would you bow with me and we'll open in prayer. God, thank you again for the gift of music. Thank you that you still inspire people to write your message in music in this way. God, we thank you for the opportunity to come together, and especially after the last few years, God, it is so good to be in your house to worship with live music like this. And God, I just thank you for the day we've had. I thank you for the message that is coming throughout this evening. And God, I pray that our hearts are open to hear something this evening that will draw each of us just a little closer to you, God. We pray your blessing over this evening. In your name we pray all these things. Amen.
Well, hello, I'm John. I'm one of the referees for tonight. I'll be leading the band, issuing penalties as necessary. I have to admit I'm nervous because it's been a few years since we've done a concert, except for when we were at Roy Thompson Hall. So it's been a privilege to work with the Music and Gospel Arts team today for a Composer's Day. And like we said, we'll let Marcus talk more about that. But I want to introduce the next item. In honor of Composer's Day, I picked an old piece. And one of the composers said to me today, how do you choose, you know, what makes you put one of those old pieces into the repertoire? And I said, because I'm old. And my school students would remind me of that. But for Composer's Day, this would have been a piece based on a tune from the Isle of Man, Marching in the Good Old Way. And you'll see the words, for I feel I, we want sweet hope of glory in my soul. For I know I have and I feel I have sweet hope of glory in my soul. Well, after 2 years and a bit of being locked away, and when we could come out, it was in groups of nine in front of a camera. It's so nice to be with an audience again. And so we hope you enjoy this setting, which in its day, when it was a new piece, would have been ahead of its time by TV composer Bruce Broughton. And unique, not a terribly joyful tune. You'll hear it. It's kind of dark and weird and wonderful. So we hope you enjoy and are blessed by Bruce Broughton's The Good Old Way. Thank you. Anybody who remembers 70s TV themes when they used to be longer than 5 seconds and they were really cool, maybe you liked that piece, because that was the guy writing some of those things like Hawaii Five-O and the Streets of San Francisco. Salvationist Time wrote for us as well. I'd like to introduce cornet soloist Marcus Venables in a piece that was written for him and for the band by Sam Creamer. Very familiar, Victory in Jesus. Would you welcome Marcus now? Thank you, Marcus, for that. I hearken back to a time, because I'm old, when we weren't allowed to play jazz in the Salvation Army. Quite glad that that has changed, and would you give him another round of applause? Well, as we think of our composers and how much the times have changed in Salvation Army banding and music making of all expressions over the last 30 years, we think that so much more has been demanded of us. style-wise and genres and things like that. And what tunes do you pick? What type of piece do you write that's going to reach out and bless somebody or draw them to Jesus? And I think on most programs, I always try to include spirituals because some people know songs of the church. Some people know contemporary praise and worship pieces. Some don't. Everybody knows spirituals. And so one of our most revered composers, Peter Graham, has put together a beautiful collection, medley of beautiful and joyful spirituals. So we hope you enjoy Seize the Day. You will recognize all these tunes. Seize the Day. Thank you.
Well, good evening. Once again, thank you all for coming and enjoying this evening. And it's called Premiere. So we've had some allusions to it already. And that is because it is in conjunction with the Territorial Composer Day. This is something that I've really wanted to put on in the music department for the territory for the past 2 years. But you know, we just couldn't book a date. Nothing was available the last little while. So we finally were able to get something secured. That's a COVID joke, in case you didn't get it. Yeah. Tonight, over the afternoon, we had 10 composers represented, two of which were in the band. They sat out during their piece so that they couldn't, put in extra high notes or something to make it sound even better. No, but the composers are all here today, except for one that was in South Korea. That's Ryan Broughton. The other composers are Isaiah Believe, Derek Robertson, Harrison Venables, Ron Allen, Paul Voss, John Van Gulik, Craig Woodland, Dave Hipperson, and Ty Watson. And it was a great afternoon of just being able to. So from a composer's point of view, you write all this music and then you hope that somebody plays it, and then, you know, it doesn't get a great read because the band might struggle on it or whatever. we were able to, you know, have the staff band read this music in rehearsal, prepare it, and then play it down and give it a good, honest read-through. And then we provided some feedback between myself, Rachel Ewing, and John Lamb. And I think it went okay. Yeah, I think it was a good time. Yeah, so we'll see. And it's only the beginning of a journey for a lot of these composers, because in the days ahead, there will be lots of follow-up dialogue, and with the hope that some of this music is revised and then eventually published and performed across Canada and the world, who knows. So as part of that, tonight we're going to feature three of those pieces that were played today. These are three pieces that in our understanding are as close to as they are going to get. They need very little revisions, and we're happy that tonight we're going to premiere Heiferdahl by Ty Watson, and then we're going to premiere How He Loves by Harrison Venables, and then the final premiere in this section will be Come Thou Fount by Craig Woodland. And as an extra bonus, we're going to actually have the composers conduct their own piece tonight. So that's quite an honor to conduct it. So next time we do this, you know, if you want to conduct the staff band, write a piece and maybe you'll get it on. So why don't you welcome the first composer, Ty Watson, as we play Heiferdahl.
After a long absence, I'm back again. Thank you. I just want to say it is so great to see you tonight. Man, this is awesome. Thank you so much for coming. We love you, and it is truly wonderful to be back. And that's from the whole band, not just the trombone section. Well, a lot has happened since we last met, but tonight I want to focus on language. I studied languages during COVID. Language can be a reflection of our times. And I discovered a language developed by the great musician Victor Borg. And we're living in times of inflation. And he developed inflationary language. Now, if you don't know what inflationary language is, let me give you a little tutor on it. Many words in English language contain numbers, like wonderful, before, create, and so on and so forth. By adding to these numbers, we can bring the language up to the level of inflation. You can add any amount, but let's start with one. So wonderful becomes tutorful. Before, be five. Create, crenine. Lieutenant, Louis Levenant. Petunia becomes Petrina. And if you add a phrase, I ate a tenderloin with my fork, it becomes I nined and an 11 anoin with my fifth. And so on and so forth. So tonight I would like to read a short excerpt from a wonderful book entitled The Tutorful Life of Anna. Twice upon a time there was a long... Twice upon a time, there was a young Lou Levenanith in the Irfithsis named Ron, who lived in Califivnia with his one-and-a-half sister, Anna. They had been very close since Anna saw the light of day for the second time. They were very proud of their five fathers, who were among the Creninters of the American Constitution. Tonight, they were celebrating her engagement to a Spanish fellow, Don Juan, but unfortunately, he had not shown up. The table was beautifully decorated with Anna's favorite flowers, three lips. Ron looked at his sister and said, "Elevenderly, you look tutorful, three night. You have never looked so lovely be five, but you have three of the saddest eyes I've ever seen. Anna really looked tutorful in spite of the embarrassment from which she had not recuperated. It was now midnight, and the clock in the distance struck 13. Suddenly in the moonlight stood Don Two, obviously intoxinated. Ron jumped to his feet. "You three-faced triple-crosser," he shouted. But Anna, trying to avoid a scandal, asked calmly, "Any two for a game of Alenitas? Anyone for a game of tennis?" Ron grabbed a piece of marinated herring. Anna warned him, "Don't throw it. Remember, you're an officer in the air, Fifes." Don screamed, "Are you two? I am 2-3. "Are you one? I am 1-2. Okay. Then Don left, and when he was one and a half way through the door, he turned, and as he wiped his five head, he said, "Anna, if I can't have you, I shall never marry. I shall always remain double. Goodbye, Anna. 3-2. Three to loop." So, that has nothing to do with what I'm about to say. We have some CDs for sale. What is the CD, you say? This is the CD. We will not raise the price by inflation. We will give you a break tonight, so come and see me after the concert. We have books as well from our 50th anniversary and a lovely book that Steve Pavey has written on our history of the band, and we would love to see you. Thank you so much.
Be still. For the presence of the Lord is moving in this place. Psalm 46. Though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the sea, be still. Though the waters form a foam and rage, be still. In the midst of a pandemic in which we've experienced so much loss, be still. In the midst of this isolation and loneliness that we've experienced, be still and know the Almighty is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress, says the psalmist in Psalm 46. That's what we know. That's what we believe. But does our knowledge always equate with our experience? Did you ever have any doubt during this time of what was happening here? Where what we were experiencing wasn't connecting so much with what we know. That must have been what it was like for the disciples when they experienced Christ on the cross. What they experienced, what they were seeing, was very different from what was actually happening, where God was on the cross reconciling the world to himself. The experience was crucifixion, but that wasn't the real story. We've been given a promise that God would never leave us nor forsake us, that God is faithful to the end. And sometimes we just need the community of faith to remind us of that. Our experience was we're falling apart. In our core, we're getting frustrated with people. We're getting frustrated with leadership. And that frustration is leaking out. We don't have all the answers, and we don't know where this is going. And so there was this inkling of doubt. And yet our faith proclaims that God is faithful. And we just need someone to remind us of that. In Psalm 13, the psalmist, things weren't going well, and so this is what he writes. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long must I wrestle with my thoughts and day after day have sorrow in my heart? How long will my enemy triumph over me? Look on me and answer, Lord my God. Give light to my eyes, or I will sleep in death. And my enemy will say, I have overcome him. And my foes will rejoice when I fall. Not in a good place. But there's something about our journey of faith that we draw on. Because it's not the first time things have not gone well. And we remember God has never failed us. And so the psalmist pauses to be still, and he concludes, but I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing the Lord's praise, for he has been good to me. In just a minute, the band is going to play a piece written by Canadian Staff band member Phil Raymond, titled Reunion. It's a sermon in music. A beautiful reminder that in the midst of everything that has gone on, that has taken us in these last few years, God has not abandoned us. It's not always as it appears. God is faithful. This piece reminds us of the journey we've been on, particularly as the body of Christ, the congregation. We've had the joy of gathering as congregations to encourage one another in faith, and this is captured in the tune Waltham. It's introduced at the beginning for the first time. The words associated are the benediction by John Newton, may the grace of Christ our Savior and the Father's boundless love with the Holy Spirit's favor rest upon us from above. Then there was this time of separation, unable to meet, this sense of loss. And this was particularly felt by those who were totally separated from the body of Christ, who were alone. And this comes across in fragmented songs, such as when the music fades. And there's this sense of loss, and there's this desire so much to return to what was. Then there was that virtual connection where we pivoted, scrambled to do something virtually. It was fun and novel. We probably came to church in our pajamas often, or your shorts or your sweatpants. But it was an attempt to connect, but it wasn't really connecting like we wanted to connect. And you'll see the songs are coming in fragments, but often interrupted. Then there's this isolation, this loss of fellowship, and that this was especially hard on those who were alone. And there were times when we just didn't see the end. However, the believer can have faith that God will overcome, and the truth is found in these words, "Do it again." Walk around these walls. I thought by now they'd fall. But you have never failed me yet, waiting for change to come, knowing the battle's won, for you have never failed me yet. Your promise still stands. Great is your faithfulness. Faithfulness. It's still in your hands. This is my confidence. You've never failed me yet. I've seen you move. You move the mountains, and I believe you can do it again. But I trust in your unfailing love. My heart rejoices in your salvation. I will sing of the Lord's praise, for he has been good to me. And then there's this anticipation. Buoyed by the hope of God's promise, the believer looks forward to rejoining fellow Christians and worshiping together. And the tune, Waltham, is reintroduced with these words. So may we remain in union with each other and the Lord, and possess in sweet communion joy which earth cannot afford. This excitement gradually builds, and we look forward to that day of reunion. The excitement of seeing firsthand the Holy Spirit move again in our worship services, and the chorus, "Do it again." I've seen you move. You move the mountains, and I believe I'll see you do it again. You made a way where there was no way, and I believe I'll see you do it again. And this piece closes with a taste of excitement, power, and glory of the Holy Spirit moving in the lives as we gather once again. Great is God's faithfulness. His love never fails. To God be the glory. The words are going to be on the screen for you to follow. Look forward to this, and we pray God's blessing as he speaks to our hearts through this sermon in music, the Canadian Staff Band.
Thank you. Thank you.
Rob back there and the band. That selection just prior to Lieutenant Colonel's devotion. I don't know if you knew all the words, some of you. There's a couple of lines in there and it says, "No work too hard for him. In faith, receive from him." Then Lieutenant Colonel said that God never fails. And that last piece, "You have never failed me yet. God, you have never failed me yet. You move the mountains." And if that's one takeaway for myself this evening is that God never fails, and maybe that's not something you've heard of before, so we want you to hear it now. There is a God who loves you, and he will not fail you, and it doesn't matter what is going on in your life. There is nothing that God cannot accomplish. We just have to have faith and receive his love and his grace, and he will do it. And if you're not entirely sure what that means, then we want you to stay after and find someone with a tunic, with the S's on the end, and ask them. Ask questions, because we want you to know God and his love. We want to thank each of you for coming and sharing in that with us. We want to thank our composers today for coming and sharing their music with us. We've had a rich heritage of brass banding here in the Salvation Army, and I believe it is still there are good things to come from the composing that we've from the composers and their music that we've heard today. To Bandmaster John Lamb and the Canadian Staff Band, thank you for sharing in this day with us. I know this is sort of your first big concert back with an audience like this, a congregation like this, but thank you for your support today. Bill, I thought your story fit perfectly with the sale of CDs, because if you see $10, you pay $11, you know, and... Oh, it's nice of you to save us a little money in these times, so thank you to the band for that. I do want to say as well a special thank you and acknowledge Lieutenant Colonel Brian Armstrong. He has been serving as the Secretary for Personnel and the Executive Officer for the Canadian Staff Band, but he will be moving very soon to the Prairie Division as Divisional Commander. So we don't want to let this opportunity go by without publicly thanking Lieutenant Colonel for his ministry with the band over the last little while. I want to say thank you to the Music and Gospel Arts Department, to Marcus, Rachel, and Simon, who've done a tremendous amount of work in putting this together, to York Minster for hosting us, and to William Chinnery and those who have supported him in their work behind the scenes. For the band, as I understand it, brings us a musical benediction. Can I share with you a benediction from Scripture? "May the God who gives endurance and encouragement give you the same attitude of mind toward each other that Christ Jesus had, so that with one mind and one voice, you may glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ." Thank you. Thank you.
night, and God bless you.